Mistress of Dawn.
I do not have the means to locate the second Hell Priest. Your celestial locator is missing a component. We will need a replacement. Your equipment launcher. The flame belch is now ready for your approval.
Flame belch, huh? Oh, there it is. Flame belch acquired. My own spaceship now. I think it goes through more than just space, but still. This is kind of awesome. Sentinel Crystal. This is the crystal selection screen. It's a sentinel crystal to permanently upgrade your health, armor, and armor capacities. Sounds about right. Select an upgrade to increase. Okay. Locking two linked upgrades also gives a bonus upgrade. Consider the bonus upgrade when selecting your sentinel crystal upgrades. That's how that works. Must have more armor, maybe. I guess I'm head. Crystal crane, achievement unlocked.
Activated and ready when you are.
Okay, so that's the portal.
This is an ARC broadcast. There are reports coming out of the quarantined hellified zone near the San Andreas Chasm. Satellite imagery show what ARC personnel believe to be the legendary Doomslayer himself fighting the mortal challenge. The Doomslayer, or Doom Guy, as he is sometimes referred to, was thought to be a myth of the Resistance, a sort of avenging angel. He was last reported to be seen on Mars, and is allegedly responsible for the destruction of the Argent Tower there. He disappeared soon afterwards. The UAC continues to deny all reports of his existence. We will continue to broadcast new information as we receive it.
That's nice. You even get news of yourself. So many interesting tidbits. Oh, mission select. And master leaders. Okay. For now. Exultia. Space. It looks abandoned. Did we get a statue or something? Ah, there it is. Extrudiana. Where is that? Nice image. Translations from the Ligre sul Tagliente Book of Kings. What voice should I give this category?
Treachery comes from our darkest cellars, driven by greed and want, for I have been deceived by the Dyak. They came north with I, the priests, as allies to our cause against the Grandmaker, and her unscrupulous methods, their silvery tongues wagging, they laid a plan for us and sowed the seed of desire for hasty triumph. They claimed knowledge of the Maker's source of power in the demon realm. A vast foundry of souls where the innocent are put to the fire for the essence. In the foundry's destruction, our victory is assured, they told us. And the force that we were, that I am, believed their lies. On their word, we sent the Doomslayer and the Night Sentinels to destroy the foundry. And the priest cast a gate for their regress. As the last veteran entered the demon's empire, our final hope of reclaiming dominion, the Dyak closed the path and left them stranded. They were trapped, lost in the eternal void by the actions of the traitors. How could I not see their intention? Am I blinded by grief for the loss of Taras Navad, of my people? We have fled again, with barely a legion of the night. Sentinels left to protect us. The Dyak are gone, returned to their mistress. Make the raids forgive my failure.
Interesting. Combat zone? Combat zone. I guess that was a gargoyle. I didn't really get to see it before I just shot it. Combat. Forgive me for trying to reload. And you tell me I haven't played Doom in a while. How dare I try to reload? Oh yeah, there's a demonic corruption battle. Ooh. It's good though. Oh no, it's dead now. Good punch. existe Blood Consumer Nether. I guess it's literally just... Okay. I can agree with this. Elevator, of course. I feel like the way to get this from runes enhance your abilities or enable new abilities. You have limited rune slots, so choose the runes that fit your playstyle. Right. Fury kills faster. Fair enough. Run it quick. Yeah, sounds about right. So now I can actually get this. So a secret down there somewhere. Down. Oh shit, he didn't die from that. Now he did. Where they have the home. There's my health back. I must have it. This is why I don't play my hard. That's the other reason why I don't play my hard. Complete all the encounters in the mission to earn weapon points. The demonic corruption meter tracks the points you've earned. Each mission has 10 points to them. Spend weapons to upgrade your arsenal. Nice. Yeah, yeah. Ancient legends speak of sentinel beasts, loyal creatures that lived as companions of the hardened warriors, often larger, swifter, and stronger than others of their kind. These animals shared instincts with their master and aided them in battle. Night sentinels never shared publicly the origin of these creatures, for only they stood worthy of them. Oh, there's also... what is that? Sentinel battery. It doesn't seem to be the way back, so... come on... Translation from the Ligra Sulte Yenda. That's not worrying at all.
In the days before man first spoke, an immense shard of rock and metal was cast onto the world from the heavens. Thunder and cataclysm shook the land as the skies were torn asunder. The cosmic spear cleft a hole through our mortal lands, pole to pole from the cold waste of the umbral plains to the fetid swamps of Ironfell. The womb of the world opened and the elemental race, the firstborn, spilled forth. They took to the skies, fierce in their emancipation. In their exultation, they brought vitality to the land, and all that felt their breath were awakened from eternal slumber. Fierce beasts and an unforgiving biosphere rose in the passing of their shadow as the ritual echoed across Argent Dunor. Fierce came the ancestrals, feral creatures invigorated by the magic of the rites. They grew to enormous heights, mighty behemoths who waged war with each other for years untold. Their battles tore the land asunder and destroyed all creation caught in their wake. The ritual continued to spread across the land, and soon the Argenta emerged from the steppes, our souls stirred into form by the power of their breath. The titans towered over the wild-blooded tribes, but found them uncowed. The secret of the sword was discovered, and in the darkness of sweltering mountain forges, we beat steel until it was strong enough to pierce bone and sever flesh. Thus we came to be, born of rock and fire, lowly in beard but risen by the strength of our will. By the blessedness of the first ones, we forged sword and shield and took the hammer to the ancestrals. We claimed dominion of creation by right of blood and magic, and the time of man came to be. With the ancestral beasts driven back to their bleak valleys, we rose. We tilled the fertile land, husbanded beasts of burden, and built towering cities. In the hallowed palace on the obsidian throne, we crowned King Omero the Father, the first of the line that shall reign in perpetuity. We built the Cathedral of Reflection to worship the First Ones and formed the Order of the Dead, whose priests paid tribute to the raids and appeased their tempestuous hunger. Our sons and daughters chose the path of the sword or the path of the alchemist, for each duty honors the gods. To our ways were righteous we were. We were not without strife. Storms and great quakes cast our spires down. Barbaric tribes laid siege to our fields in search of the great gifts Mother Argenta had bestowed upon our world. And the song of the raid call threatened to drive lesser men into madness. We were not lesser men. We defended that which the first ones gifted us. Our lands and right to the bounty held within. We beat back the barbarian hordes and hardened our resolve. We rose above the fire, our bodies and souls tempered, and an unbreakable will was shaped in the forge of battle. What emerged was the heart of our legion, the Order of the Night Sentinels. That was a lot longer than I expected. Same.
What do we have on now?
Despite their transgressions against the Covenant, they are still of Sentinel blood. What you interfere with now is bigger than you can imagine. It is written. It is their time to give penance. If you continue, you will bring down the Heaven's wrath.
Yeah, I don't care.
You are but one man. They are no longer your people to save.
Bye. Innovate ruled over Sentinel Prime for many years as its warrior patriarch, ordained protector of the sovereign Sentinel worlds. The Sentinel people, defined by a legacy of war, deem only those of warrior caste fit to rule, and in times of battle it is expected that the king lead from the battlefield rather than from the safety of the throne. As it is written in Sentinel law, a king unfit for battle is likewise unfit to rule. For millennia, the Sentinel people have secured their civilization against the threat of invasion from beast and human alike, passing the mantle of battle to each subsequent generation, and refining the craft of war into an art of ultimate mastery. Even in times of peace, the Night Sentinels remain vigilant, developing new technologies of conquest, each the more capable of securing their dominion across the sovereign worlds. Okay, at least that one wasn't too... I do not understand those, sadly. I wonder if they're actually... They seem like Arabic, but... Whatever they are, I wonder if they're an actual language or if they were just made up to look like an actual language. Yep. Okay, you see. Takes me right back here. Wait, and what was... That is, I need to grab that. Oh, that's my target anyway. So, this way? This way. Should I save up? And I want to... That might also be useful. So what do we have for you? I do like the micro missiles. Okay, so inventor. Okay. I'm supposed to go this way. So I have this now.
This sentinel battery can be used to provide additional power to your ship. Several modules remain unused. Finding more batteries will enable you to utilize the full functions of your command station.
Fair enough. Oh. That's my way. Also, I'm here now. Right. Bye, guys. Boy. This is here. That's from underneath. Not sure what that means. Okay, so I'm supposed to go over there. First of all. Oh. Okay, so this, yeah. Seems like I need to get there. Well, I finally found the automat.